between Fort Worth and Dallas, Texas in Arlington at the luxurious AT&T Stadium. Set for football now at AT&T Stadium. Brandon Aubrey has the honors, and we are underway here in Arlington. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. He'll start on the ground here on first down. And he works his way forward to pick up 4 yards there, second down.
Nice chunk of yards on first down. It really opens up your options for what you want to do on second. You go right back to him and hope he explodes, or sucker the defense in before throwing over the top.
Ball on the 30 now. Here's second and 6. They'll send the tight end in motion left. Out of the gun, it's Burrow. And this throw incomplete. Now the defender all over him that time, but it's going to lead to third down.
Looked like both sides were anticipating a quick throw there, and the defense was ready to jump in and deny it, and they did.
This defense looking for an early stop. This is third down and 6. They'll look to throw here. He had a man open, but he missed him, and it's incomplete.
That was their first third down try of the game, and clearly something was off in the execution of that play. Good news, they've got a whole game left to clean that up and start clicking on those key third down throws.
On fourth down, the rookie Ryan Rico on to punt for the Bengals. Kevontae Turpin deep for the Cowboys. And now a low liner. I think he mishit it. Only 29 yards on the punt there. Definitely not his best. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a first and 10. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. They've got good starting field position as they come up here first and 10 at the 39-yard line. They run here with Rico Dowdle. And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up.
Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
Second down and 8. And they'll keep leaning on the running game. Back to the ground. And he'll get about 3 here up to the 44-yard line. Third and 5. Rush. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And he will have a Cowboys first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
I don't care who you put on him, he's going to be a handful in one-on-one throws.
Yeah, right now, you're right. They're in man-to-man, maybe need some safety help.
I would say that'd be a good idea. Double-team him somehow. I'm going to have to make someone else beat me rather than let him shred my defense.
Back to throw, Rush. And that is incomplete.
I think we'll see more of them trying to get him the football out of the backfield. They love what he can do in open space, and they believe that he creates mismatches they can exploit.
Now a second and 10. Play fake. Here's Rush. The Bengal pressure gets him that time. Down he goes. Sam Hubbard making his presence felt in the backfield.
They tried to go with a little play action there, but nobody on the defensive side bit.
Yeah, they adjusted in time and in a big way and ultimately got the sack. On offense, sometimes you're running play action just to set up a certain blocking technique. In this case, none of it worked.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. To the sideline and incomplete.
One first down here, and that's all, folks. Good work by this defense to hold things in check and force a punting situation.
And the Cowboys going to bring on Brian Anger to punt on fourth down. Back deep is Charlie Jones. This is away, but boy, headed straight for the sidelines. And this will be out of bounds, and they spot it at the 15-yard line. Not too bad.
Cincinnati coming back onto the field here for their second drive.
The crowd may be losing just a little bit of the edge after back-to-back punts.
They want some big plays. They want to see some offense. They want to see somebody break away, whether it's through the air or on the ground. Now it'll be interesting to see where the patience is on both sides. Each head coach, can you hang in there and not try and force something that could put your team in some jeopardy?
And boy, showing how tough he can be to bring down, just fighting his way forward to pick up 7 yards.
But you often say that sort of opens the playbook now, second and short. What do you think, early shot here?
I like where you're going. Obviously, we've been together for a while because you know me. I want to take that shot early and loosen things up.
Another run for Brown on second down.
And he's able to get up here to the 26.
4 yards the pickup, first down.
Let's face it, when you have a guy who can pick up those types of runs and keep the chains moving or stay ahead of the chains, you're making everyone else on offense happy because you're opening things up to allow for a whole lot of different play calls.
They keep it on the ground. Again, it's Brown.
And not a whole lot there. Maybe a yard to the 27.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
Still 9 yards to go on second down from the 27. This is Brown going up the middle. He'll get a yard, that's all, as they get him down at the 28.
Early down stuff's to put this offense in a precarious position. We know that securing the point of attack, especially against the big-bodied guys in the middle of this D, has got to be priority one.
Here now, a third down and 8. From the shotgun, Joe Burrow. Able to find the open man. That's complete.
And he's going to be out up around the 45-yard line.
A Bengal first down on the 16-yard pickup there.
Well, it certainly feels like there are more stars at the tight end position than there were even 10 years ago. And I think it's become more of a glamour position because of the ways it can hurt a defense, and guys want to be involved. They can be in line, close to the line of scrimmage. They can split out like receivers. But hands, route running, speed, and some toughness to go across the middle, you put it all together, you got a heck of a tight end candidate.
Well, that's always a good place to throw it just because he's one of the biggest targets not only on this team but in the National Football League.
And you and I both know the quarterbacks love these large body tight ends, and why not? Nowadays, they're really wide receivers who are just taller and have a little bit more weight. These guys catch the football, make big plays downfield. In the old days, we wanted them to block. Now coaches want them to catch the football first.
That's going to be a 6-yard gain. It leaves him with third down and just a yard to go.
That was a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
And he is going to have a Bengals first down as this defense unable to hold. It's a 7-yard gain there on 3rd and 2.
They've been moving the ball well, but this drive was in danger of stalling out. Fortunately, this is a nice throw here, and they're able to pick up a new set of downs.
Here's Burrow. It's complete to Brown, right side. And he's going to get it down to the 33-yard line here. They'll wind up getting 7 on the play, and it'll be second down. We've seen quite a bit of the short passing game here early on first quarter, haven't we?
We have, and I think it works a couple of ways for this team because, number one, you throw the short game until they stop it. And if they're not going to stop it, you keep throwing it, and occasionally you'll break a tackle and turn into a bigger game. Also, if they start to creep up, start to pressure receivers,
and he will take it on in for a Bengals touchdown. Chase Brown, 33 yards. And the Bengals will claim the early lead as they're on the board first here tonight.
Well, partner, that was another explosive run. And one thing I've learned in our time in this game, Yes, the offensive line has to get a lot of credit, but for big runs to occur, the wide receivers have to block well downfield.
And then you have to have a good guy carrying the ball too, right?
Oh, without a doubt. You need that difference maker lugging the rock.
After the touchdown, McPherson on to kick this one away. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape, up past the 30.
Second drive forthcoming here for the Dallas Cowboys.
Over on the sideline, hoping to hit that reset button between possessions. Last time out, they had to punt it away. This time, hoping to finish this thing off in the end zone.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Here's Rush to throw. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. A gain of 32 that time.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play that picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
Here's the first carry for Ezekiel Elliott. And this will go as a gain of 7 as he gets it to the 30-yard line. The success there, Charles, coming on the outside of the field of the ground game. Curious to see if that continues as we progress.
Yeah, we often talk about a variety in play calling and usually between run and pass. But in this case, with strictly the run game, you can be creative there as well. Run it inside, run it outside, keep the defense off balance.
Throwing here, Rush. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
They've given him some different looks here defensively in the early going. He's only hit 2 of his first 5 passes. With a big third down coming up, he's hoping he's got a play dialed up that can take advantage of whatever the defense throws at him.
In need of a conversion on third down. They had the big play to start the drive. Not much sense. Operating from the gun. Rush. And that went to the right side and incomplete.
Yeah, it's still early in the game. No sense taking a chance on third down and forcing one into traffic. So I like the wise play he made there. Get it to the sideline out of bounds where no one's going to have a chance at it.
So on fourth down, out is Brandon Aubrey for the Cowboy field goal.
It'll be a 47-yard attempt from the left hash. And this will split the uprights. It's right down the middle, and they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3.
Well, in a close game like this, obviously you want the touchdown, but certainly they will take the 3.
And they'll be okay with that, but let's throw a little credit to the defense as well. And I'm just glad this doesn't come down to a debate, right? Which side won, partner? Because the defense, hey, we didn't give up a touchdown. The offense, hey, we put 3 on the board. Either way you look at it, I think both sides gained something out of that drive.
So after the made field goal, back out is Aubrey to kick this away. And they'll get him down inside the 30 at the 27. Cincinnati's offense coming back here onto the field. Burrow and the Bengals with a first and 10
at their own 27. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive.
He's going to have the hook up here to Chase.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. First play of the drive going for 14 and also going for a first down. If you're going to blitz, likely going to leave you in man coverage with this guy, and that is less than ideal.
It is, because just about any offense that has an elite receiver, if you blitz and have him in man coverage, you're going to him, even if he has an elite defender on him, because he usually knows where the ball is before the defender does.
So they'll get 8 out of that completion, and they'll be left with 2nd and a couple. From midfield now, Burrow. Open man is Yoshivas.
It's the first time that they've looked his way tonight, and he comes up with a first down on the play. Off the play fake, here's Burrow. He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone. And he's got it. Touchdown, Bengals.
Ja'Marr Chase,
44 yards. And they are able to add on to their advantage.
And now before we get to the extra point, remember all touchdowns do have to be confirmed by the replay official. McPherson now for the extra point.
And this one's right through to make it a 14-3 ball game.
After the touchdown, McPherson on to kick this one away. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. The Dallas offense back out onto the field.
And last time able to get three. It's not what they wanted. They wanted six, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for six.
And that one going to come up short. Low throw.
Not only did he have a chance to scan the field there, it felt like he had a chance to scan it twice. The protection was that good. Unfortunately for him, the coverage downfield, equally good.
Second and 10.
To throw is Rush.
Got his man. It's Jonathan Mingo.
And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. 23 yards the pick up there.
And that play came together really well for them as he found open space, makes the catch, and gets down to the 1 yard line. You know he's kicking himself right now. He thought he had a chance to get a touchdown and put that in his ledger. Instead, his team gets a chance to cash in over these next few plays.
And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back. Let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
And they'll run on the inside handoff,
and he'll go down here at the 35-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup, and that's all they needed to move the sticks. We haven't seen much from him running the football here in this first quarter.
No, you're right about that. We haven't seen much of him at all so far. They've stacked him up pretty well, but when you're trying to run the football, sometimes you got to play the long game. Keep handing it to him, and some of those runs that aren't working now, they turn into 6, 7, 8, and maybe more later on.
A short one there, taken in by Ferguson.
After one, a 14-3 ball game.
Start of the second quarter, and it's the Cowboys in possession. Ball on the 28-yard line. Here's second and 3. They go play action with Rush. They're looking for Lamb, but it's intercepted. And the Bengals are going to get the football here as he gets this up to the 38-yard line. Burrow going to lead up the Bengals here, first and 10
at their 38.
They'll start this drive out on the ground. And he'll muscle his way up to the 43 for a pickup of right around 5.
Nice satisfying run on first down for the offense, picking up 5, which means defensively, the thought process is entirely different. You don't want to panic, but at the same time, you're saying to each other, we've got to tighten this down. We can't give up gains like that.
Now it's Burrow. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes.
Multiple players combined for their team's first sack of the game.
And no matter what the situation, the O-line just hates that because they feel like they didn't protect little brother back there, right?
Man, that's just so difficult for them because just think about every single play. When you decide to throw the football, you're dealing with some of the best athletes on the planet. You talk about guys, if they weren't playing football, they'd be starring in the NBA at power forward. It's a really difficult task.
This will be caught by Brown. And he'll go down to the ground at the 39, and obviously that's well short of the first. 5 yards, not enough, and it'll be fourth down.
And that's a play that's not uncommon on third and long because the offense is just hoping that somehow they can get a guy in space and follow some blockers downfield. Does a pretty nice job there getting a few yards, but he ends up getting stopped before he can get the first down.
And on fourth down, on is the punt team sending this one away. It'll wind up just a 35-yard punt, no return.
And it will be first and 10 as they take over.
The offense for the Cowboys now working their way back onto the field.
It's been very much a slow start for them. 3 drives and just the 3 points, CD.
Yeah, if you're into the points per drive ratio, that answer is 1. And that's not going to get it done in a ball game. They've got to find a way to finish these drives in end zones, not having balls go through goalposts.
And he'll be taken down here at about the 23-yard line. Von Bell up to make the tackle.
If they want to start getting back into this game, it behooves them to get better on first down.
Yeah, certainly not what they were looking for there out of the opening play of this drive.
Now 2nd and 9.
Now Rush. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
So another incompletion there. He's hitting on fewer than half his pass attempts in this one, and that is not a winning formula.
Yeah, so let's make sure we give a little bit of credit to the defense here. They've given him a lot to think about, a lot of different looks, and he seems a little bit confused trying to complete passes.
On 3rd down, he'll drop to throw.
Throwing left sideline there, but it's incomplete.
It's going to be another frustrating end to a drive here. This offense, they've not been able to get anything going in this first half. And now it's going to be time to gather on the sidelines and try and figure out what's going wrong. Who has an idea? Who has a plan? Time to implement it.
On is the punter, Brian Anger, to kick this one away. Fair catch signaled for and taken just shy of the 30-yard line. So possession goes over here on the punt.
And the Bengals take over 1st and 10.
They're passing here, Joe Burrow. Now a short one to Gesicki. He's brought down at the 34. Call it a gain of 4.
They gave up the completion there, but this is what zone defenses count on. Catching the ball and not much run after the catch.
Line of scrimmage, the 24. This is 2nd and 6.
Shotgun handoff to Brown here. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down.
74 yards for him on the ground so far tonight as he has been terrific in this first half.
Now this is an example of breaking down a defense because on a lot of these runs, he's getting past the point of attack. And guess what he's doing? Forcing the secondary guys to have to make a lot of tackles.
They go right back to the ground here in Brown.
And a strong run that time as he's across midfield and down to the 43.
They get 10 more there, and I believe that'll be enough for another first down. It will.
I'm not sure how much more evidence they need, partner, than to understand that if they don't start to slow him down, it's going to be a long afternoon here at the stadium because He is just shredding them at this point. And let's face it, coming into the game, they knew he would be the focal point of their attack. This is going to take an 11-man unit on the defensive side to start making plays.
Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a first down again.
This guy's well on his way now to a big game on the ground. It's another good run there. Puts him over the century mark in yardage, and we're still in the second quarter.
They go play action with Burrow. Now a short one to Gesicki. Call it a gain of 6 on the play, and that's going to bring up second down.
So much goes into a successful play, doesn't it? How about that play action there, freezing the defense just enough to bring the tight end free downfield for the completion.
From the 21, here's a 2nd and 4. Burrow looking to pass. That's complete. Once again, it's Gesicki. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down. This drive, it's been a good mix. 3 passing plays, 3 runs, hitting on all 3 of those passes, and the last one putting him in the red zone.
So wouldn't you think play action right here? Because you've got the ability and had the ability to run it and throw it. Go play action and take your shot at the end zone.
Now it's Burrow. That one thrown away from the pocket. The officials kind of looking at each other, but they'll say there was a receiver in the area, so no penalty, just an incomplete pass.
No receivers open downfield, so instead of forcing the ball to the sideline, he's going to throw this one down to Fort Worth. He'd rather have the incompletion than the turnover.
Now Burrow. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. That'll leave them with a 3rd and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards there.
Ah, that's tough to play zone defense when they can just curl up right there in front of you.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, we talk about finding the soft spot defensively. How do you make sure they don't find the soft spot like they did there?
Tough to do, because what they normally will do is run routes that'll pull you out of that.
Touchdown, Bengals! Mike Gesicki. From 3 yards out, and the Bengals add 6 to their lead. So 3 drives, 3 touchdowns, and they're a PAT from going up 21-3.
And there's no doubt in my mind, you're liking what you're seeing so far, aren't you?
It's been unbelievable. Like a well-oiled machine, if you will.
What's really tough, though, that defense, they're leaping the shadows at this point. They don't know which way to go. They're being hit in every direction, and they have no answers thus far.
After the touchdown, McPherson on to kick this one away. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get this up to the 29. Dallas offense set for this next drive. And this, let's face it, an important drive if they're going to get back into this ballgame.
Think about going into the locker room down 21-10. As opposed to 21-3. 21-10, a little more optimism, a little more bounce around the locker room, a little more discussion about how they're going to finish this thing off. 21-3, I think discouragement clouds that locker room.
Yeah, and I think a touchdown much bigger than a field goal on this drive just to get into the end zone and get that momentum.
A good pickup there, a 22.
Now that's the kind of big play you'd like to see. This first half, it hasn't gone their way, and they could use a shot in the arm, something to perk them up a bit. And they get one here in the passing game.
On first down, they'll go to the ground attack. And he fights forward for a modest 2-yard gain, 2nd down.
In order to play really good run defense when you're playing a 3-4, those 3 guys up front, the nose tackle and the guys they call the defensive ends, they're usually big, big people, because they're going to have to eat up a lot of blockers, because it's usually 5-on-3. And when they do their job well, guys who play on the inside, those inside linebackers, they're able to just roam and hit.
And he's going to get this inside the 30. A good-looking drive for the Cowboys so far. It's a first down.
And a nice job by the 2 of them to not only connect on the pitch and the catch,
but to carry over their practice work to the game field. They saw the adjustment by the defense, made an adjustment themselves, and picked up the first down.
On first down, they'll go to the ground attack. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine.
Oh, there's plenty of traffic waiting for him up the middle, but give him credit, he tried barreling through anyway. They're fortunate to get a yard out of that one.
Second and nine.
Off the play fake. Rush.
That is caught by Lamb.
And he's out of bounds. Almost gets to the 10. A good-looking drive for the Cowboys so far. It's a first down.
Well, these guys have definitely been outplayed in the first half. I like their countenance. I like the way that they haven't panicked out there, the way they're carrying themselves. They're starting to move the ball. And what you have to do, maintain your poise and start to put together some drives.
Got a man, and he hits him in stride. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and two.
Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two. Wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage.
Here's second and two now from the three.
Inside give to Elliott. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1 yard line. It's a 3 yard pickup, and that sets up a first and goal.
Not too many more ideal situations in second and two in order to try and pick up a first down. They ran it and picked it up.
First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game.
Elliott is in. Touchdown, Dallas.
Sometimes offenses can get too cute down near the goal line, but there's nothing fancy about this one. As Coach Lombardi would say, we get a seal here, and we get a seal here, and we run this play in the alley. And that's good work to hit the hole hard and finish in the end zone.
Now the extra point up and good by Aubrey.
And it makes the score 21-10.
So after the touchdown, Aubrey now to kick this one away.
And able to get this out to the 25. The Bengals set to take over.
Burrow and the Bengals with a first and 10
at their 25-yard line. They'll send the tight end in motion. They'll start on the ground here on first down. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line.
110 yards rushing for him now to this point.
On any explosive run, you can almost feel the ground shaking, and that's from the offensive lineman creating space for their runners. I had an old coach tell me before that he always told his runners, run around the offensive line in pregame. Get used to the ground shaking so you don't trip and fall when it happens in a game.
And Burrow going to be hit and taken down. They got him. Getting home that time to Marvin Overshow.
Here's Burrow, setting up to throw it. He's got his target. That's complete. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. Well, that's one way to convert on third down, picking up 26 yards.
Well, things are definitely going right for them here in the first half. Pick a down, any down, even third down, no problem. They get a connection there and pick up a fresh set of downs, continuing to move the ball.
The tight end in motion right. Burrow will throw. Now a short one to Gesicki. So the completion good for seven there. And it's second down.
Such a tough position to defend near the line, even when you add a second defender, but the big man shrugged off the extra body and made the play call a success.
Now second and three.
They'll drop to throw.
This one complete to Yoshibas.
And he's going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys 21. The Bengals passing game finding a rhythm. They've got another first. Creeping up on a minute to play in this first half. To the air again, Burrow. This pass complete to Higgins. And he takes it down to the 10-yard line. Another nice gain. That's now 30 yards between those last two plays. Now the Bengals going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock stops here with 46 seconds remaining in the first half. A chance to really cap off a big first half here as they come up on first and goal. From the shotgun, it's Burrow. And that one complete once again to Higgins. And a nice job to break free of one tackle, but it slowed his momentum somewhat, and he's taken down right after. Nice job defensively to hold him to four, and now it's second and goal.
Well, if you do read man coverage, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people on it.
The 6-yard line, the line of scrimmage on second and goal. And he's got it. Touchdown.
T. Higgins. As the first half is winding down, and the Bengals would extend their lead here just before halftime.
That score that they just gave up there, that's a tough one for their defense to swallow because they've had a tough time through the first two quarters. They really were determined to get a stop there. Unable to do so, that makes their comeback hopes that much more difficult.
Extra point by McPherson, up and good. And the lead is up to 18 now. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. And the tackle going to be made right there at the 25-yard line. And the Cowboys going to go on offense one final time in this first half. And with 7 seconds remaining, not much time to really do anything.
Likely time for one final snap as they start out first and 10.
Lamb will go in motion. Here's a fake on the jet sweep, and instead a give up the middle.
And he'll just push his way forward for a few as the clock will run. And that'll do it for the end of the second quarter. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. It's the Cowboys who get the football first, and they trail here as well as we resume action in the third quarter.
And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28.
Out come the Cowboys now as he'll go on offense first here in this third quarter.
And you have to think, Charles, down 3 scores already, they need to play an almost perfect second half to have a solid chance.
And that absolutely starts with finding some way to put together a touchdown drive here. They need to be smart, fast, efficient, get the ball into the end zone, and do it again multiple times in order to have a chance to win this game.
And he'll take this up near the 35, maybe the 34.
It's Logan Wilson there to bring him down.
Running lanes were at a premium in the first half, but he's able to find some room there, and he's hoping that that's a precursor of a big second half.
Here's a second and 5.
Rush. And his throw here is incomplete. A misconnection there. He's hit on just 50% of his passes thus far. That's not where you want to be.
Now you see the evolution of the game. You go back to the quarterbacks of old, 50% would be terrific because they threw the ball downfield almost every time they threw it. Now with the short passing game, you should be above 60% just to be in the average range.
Back to throw, Rush. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And he will have a Cowboys first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And that's well executed there on third down, and I love the confidence that they had to let their tight end try and find some space in the middle of the field right in their quarterback's line of vision. And QBs love to make that easy throw, and they hooked up there for a first down.
A first down carry by Elliott. And a solid run here as he'll pick his way down to the 42-yard line. Back-to-back nice gains, that one for 14 yards and another first.
The more football I watch, the more I want to check and see if teams are going to panic when they're down on the scoreboard. And this team has shown no signs of doing that. A lot of the time, they come out after the half, things haven't worked so well in the first go-around, they want to throw the football like crazy. But the way to open up throwing the ball is to run it, and they've run it well here to start the second half.
2 yards the loss, second and 12.
This defense is just flat getting after it. They have not given up much of anything in the run game. Case in point right there.
So the first down run lost a couple. Now they come up second and 12. And they'll give him another shot here on the ground. And some good tackling there as he stopped up at about the 41.
That ground game contained again there, Charles, and that's really a big reason that they're trailing right now.
And give a lot of credit to that defensive front. That's exactly what they worked for all week, to try and take away the run game, make them one-dimensional. In the battle of game plans, theirs has been superior.
On third down, they'll try and run for it on the draw.
And a good job of finding the open space to run as he's down close to the 30 here.
Give him 10 there. Good enough for a Cowboy first down.
First downs have not come easy, and neither have runs like this throughout this game.
Absolutely not. He finally felt like, whoa, a sigh of relief. We got something going in the running game. Here's Rush to throw. Over the middle, hauled in by Lamb. So the completion good for just 3, and it'll be second down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
Throwing here, Rush. Gonna throw deep for the end zone. And this is caught for a Cowboy touchdown. CeeDee Lamb, 28 yards.
And the Cowboys are able to cut into that deficit.
That's a score you felt they had to have here in the third quarter to get back in this game.
And you know that there was an emphasis on their side. Hey, we know this. We know where we are. But sometimes that binds you up so much that you try too hard, you don't get the score. A perfect combination of urgency, yet relaxed enough to get it done.
So after the touchdown, Aubrey now to kick this one away.
And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. So here are the Bengals now as they get their first possession of this second half.
And they were terrific in the first half, built up a sizable lead, and it's just been cut into a bit following the opening drive score on the other side. But this is a unit that has to be itching to get the football again.
You can say that again. They've got to be pretty eager because, let's face it, they've had to sit through halftime, then sit on the sidelines and watch that drive. So you can bet that they're saying, let's get on with this. We got to go out there and get some more points.
Solid way to start the drive, 13 yards, picking up the first.
I'll tell you what, a lot of those mid-range throws have been available because sometimes teams get too concerned about the deep ball and they leave too much space in front of them, and these guys have been taking advantage so far.
Here's Burrow.
Throw left side complete to Chase.
He's still on his feet. And all the way in for a Cincinnati score.
Ja'Marr Chase
with his second touchdown of the night.
And the Bengals are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead.
Boy, he has been fun to watch throwing the football in this one. It's certainly not fun for that defense, though, Charles. Now up to four touchdown passes in this ball game.
Yeah, we're supposed to be neutral, but I'm feeling their pain right now because he has absolutely carved up this secondary. A clinic on how to attack a defense and take them out of the game.
After the touchdown, McPherson on to kick this one away.
And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. And now Dallas gets set to take the field.
I kind of feel like they've reached a do-or-die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off an impressive comeback, it has to start right here, right now.
Yeah, now they've got a final chance to get out of this situation, but they also understand they've got to move the ball and move it fast. In addition, they need to save as much time so they can get two more possessions.
And this has been a recurring theme tonight for sure. Nowhere to run. Back to the line of scrimmage, that's all. And as a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle, that's what we saw right there.
Yeah, that's what their job is. And really, a lot of the time, they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game because, you know, those defensive ends are like in a sprinter stance. They're just like...
And he'll be taken down by the Bengal pressure.
B.J. Hill breaking through to get him to the ground. It's a loss of 7.
Now Charles dealing with a 3rd and long. They'll have to try to go back to the air again and this time avoid the sack.
Certainly hard to try to establish momentum when all you're doing is going backwards, not protecting the passer, and he gets dumped on his backside.
Now on 3rd and long, they'll look to throw. Under pressure again, and down he goes again.
Trey Hendrickson showing off his pass rush repertoire that time.
I think we've seen this before. Someone's down 3 scores, that situation there is just going to add to their growing frustrations, don't you think?
Yeah, a bad number 3 right now. 3-score game, 3rd quarter, 3 and out, not what they wanted. And you can tell on the sideline, those faces are getting a little bit longer as this one goes.
Fair catch taken just inside the 40-yard line.
A 40-yard punt, no return. And the Bengals will take over here 1st and 10.
Now the Cincinnati offense ready to see what they can do here.
Team, they are rolling right now, Charles. They've scored on 3 straight possessions. You look at the scoreboard, and they pretty much right now got this thing on cruise control.
Yeah, and this is that time of game where you and I have to be prepared, right? Isn't this kind of like the empty the bucket time where you have to go into your blowout material and make sure we have some different things? That's what we're staring at right now, the way this one is going.
15 yards is the pickup there, and the drive starting very nicely. 1st down.
And while we may be looking at the scoreboard, this offense certainly is not, because they're showing no signs of backing down, even with a 3-score lead here in the 3rd quarter. I think they keep taking their shots. They've seen blown leads happen throughout this league. They don't want to fall victim to it themselves.
Open man is Yoshivas.
So the completion good for 6 yards, and it's 2nd down.
Now off the bootleg.
This is caught inside the 15. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10.
This offensive game plan has just been sensational. I mean, when you think about all the different ways they've gotten their receivers open so far, it's really been impressive. Scheme, design, execution.
Now it's Burrow.
And he's got his man in stride, complete.
And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on 2nd down.
Second and a couple.
An inside give, Brown. And he's going to get this back to the 3-yard line and no further. He got maybe a half yard at most, but officially they'll be left with a 3rd and 2.
That time they're able to bottle him up, but he's having a really nice game.
I agree with that. Let's just go big picture, right? Every back that's in the Hall of Fame had carries where they didn't gain yardage or they lost yardage, but you stick with them, don't you? When they're having a good game, keep feeding them.
From the gun on 3rd down is Burrow. Oh, he had him. He was open, but he couldn't get it to him. It's incomplete.
Not too many missteps in the red zone thus far. He was going for his 5th touchdown pass. His man couldn't shake free there, but boy, you know he's going to take another shot before this one's over.
Yeah, exactly, because you know 3 is good, 4 is excellent. You get 5, that's a whale of a game.
McPherson's kick is good,
and that will extend their lead even further.
So after 5 touchdowns offensively, hey, maybe it's time to get the kicker a little work, and he's able to connect there.
I love that empathetic side of you. You're worried about him getting some action, getting to be a part of the game. Well, he got in and got it done.
So after the made field goal, here's McPherson to send this one away.
And they'll have very good starting field position as he's up just shy of the 40.
And out now come the Cowboys.
They're down 3 touchdowns to this point, needing to put something together as they have it 1st and 10.
They'll start this drive out on the ground. And able to get this one all the way up to about the 46-yard line. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave them with a 2nd and 3.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on 1st down, that fits the bill.
2nd down and 3.
Lamb will go in motion.
Now a fake on the jet sweep, and they'll instead run up the middle.
And he'll get it out to midfield. Looks like, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50.
A gain of 5, good enough for the 1st down.
Well, you know they had a 3rd down play on standby just in case, but he says no need with that carry. Runs like that will continually earn him more work in this and future contests.
Play fake. Here's Rush.
He's going to go for a big play downfield. And incomplete on the deep ball.
That's some good closing speed there defensively because that looked open for a minute. But that's great work with the ball in the air. Never gave up. Converged on his man and broke the play up.
Dallas, Texas is the spot. 3rd quarter inside AT&T Stadium. Glad you're with us. 2nd and 10.
A give to Elliott running left. And he tried to bounce it outside, but they'll stop him behind the line.
2 yards the loss, and now 3rd and 12.
But if these guys are going to chop into that deficit, they're going to have to do a much better job in the run game. Caught behind the line of scrimmage, no yardage would be found.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on 3rd down.
Out of the shotgun, Rush.
And that will be incomplete.
Looks like another empty possession offensively. And you're at that point in the game where you can't afford too many more of these. So this is going to require some heavy thinking on the sideline to figure out what they can do to crack this defense.
Here's Brian Anger now as he's on to punt for the 4th time tonight. And the kick's away as he angles this one for the sideline. And no return possible here as they angle this one out of bounds.
Cincinnati set to take over once again. Burrow going to lead up the Bengals here 1st and 10
at their own 26.
And they'll begin here with a run by Brown. 116 yards for him on the ground now. He has been a tough man to bring down all night.
Well, I think after that run, the defense getting back in the huddle and looking at each other and maybe starting to question their confidence a bit. They gave up a significant run, 6 yards, and now you're saying to yourself, how do we stop them, and do I have enough confidence to make a play?
Another run for Brown on second down.
And he'll be brought down right around the 37.
A gain of five, good enough for the first down.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time and making it work.
They're passing here, Joe Burrow.
Quick hitter here, it's complete.
And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled.
They picked up 5 yards last time. Now they double it and get 10 here.
And passing yardage-wise, now up over 350 in this game. Pretty nice performance.
Definitely that, which usually means you're putting a lot of pressure on guys trying to cover. If you're a defensive back and they put over 350 yards on you, you've had a long day. The key to everything, if you're doing it without throwing interceptions or turning the ball over.
And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35.
One quarter remains here on a Sunday night. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports.
Back now in Arlington. A lot of folks starting to make their way to the parking lot. Their guys trail big here to begin quarter number four.
They'll motion the tight end across the formation. They'll look to throw here on first down. And this will be incomplete.
Well, fourth quarter with a 3-score lead here, Charles, but they're still going back to the air and looking for more points.
Well, with this game well in hand, it's an opportunity for the guys to come off the bench and get a chance to play. And a lot of coaches, they want to run their full playbook no matter who's on the field.
Now they go play action now. Burrow to the sideline, and wow, what a catch there. He doesn't get a lot, but he was able to get the feet down complete. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down.
Let's make this one simple. What a catch, especially the finishing part of getting his feet in bounds, toe tapping, and of course, foot dragging.
Little tapestry, if you will.
Oh, I like it.
Able to find the open man. That's complete. And he is going to have a Bengals first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
He's been the go-to guy. They needed a big play there on third down. Went his way. It worked out.
Doesn't matter whether they scouted it or that they think he's going to get the ball. He has a knack for finding his way open and completing the connection.
Burrow looking to pass. Now a short one to Gesicki, and he is brought down at the 22 after a gain of two, and it brings up second down.
Here's a second and 8.
Now it's Burrow.
This will be caught by Brown. It'll go down as a gain of 6. And now 2 yards to go on third down.
In motion goes the tight end. That is caught, and he'll take this into the end zone for a Bengal TD. Andre Yoshibas from 17 yards out, and the Bengals up the lead to 4 scores now here in this fourth quarter.
And you wonder now if he might be able to remove the helmet, put on the baseball cap, and watch the rest of this one from the sideline. His 5th touchdown pass of the game.
Say that again. Did you say 5th touchdown pass of the game?
Yes, sir.
Boy, that's a heck of a performance, isn't it? Because they've had no answer for him at all game long. Receivers have been open constantly, and he hasn't missed a single one of them.
After the touchdown, McPherson on to kick this one away. Yeah. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line.
So out come the Cowboys now as their offense gets set to take over.
Well, we said it at halftime that they would need a nearly perfect second half to erase that deficit that they were facing, CD. But unfortunately, the second half has pretty much been a carbon copy of the first.
Yeah, that early lead was almost insurmountable the way their opponent was playing. And partner, they do have some good news, though. This one is getting close to being over, and they can try and hit the reset button starting tomorrow.
Short completion, just 4 yards, and it'll be second down.
You got the big lead defensively, willing to give them that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle them after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
Now Rush. His throw incomplete.
Well, the trials and tribulations of being a quarterback in this league, it's tough. It's got to be wearing on him out there.
Well, he has been sacked a number of times. He had an interception, so I'm going to give him a skosh of credit for hanging in there and trying to make something happen, despite the amount of pressure he's been under this entire game.
The offense on third down tonight, they've converted 3 times and 8 chances. This will be 3rd and 6. He's got his target. That's complete. And he will have a Cowboys first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And with this game well in hand, perhaps we are seeing the coverage lighten up a little bit as they got burned there a bit for a first down.
But we certainly know the coach isn't happy along the sideline because he certainly wants them to finish this one out the way they started it. He doesn't want to give up any soft completions, no late points. He wants his lead to stay right where it is.
Oh, this one incomplete. The pressure got to him as he released it, and it's second down.
We've seen this quite a few times in this game. Offensive line unable to keep leverage, unable to keep people away, facing a lot of pressure. Fortunate just to get rid of it.
One of the reasons they're down is that inability, though, to stop the pressure. We saw another example of it there.
To throw is Rush.
A short one there, taken in by Ferguson.
5 yards. Now it's 3rd and 5.
Well, the strategy was evident there. Get it to your tight end and make it a one-on-one play with a cornerback. Who's usually going to win that one?
The tight end, but not there.
Not in this situation. How about the corner defeating that logic and making a really nice tackle?
Rush working from the gun. Pass taken in by his big tight end.
And he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Bengals 26. A big third down pickup of 20 yards.
Well, this game was decided a while ago, and that completion there is going to artificially inflate his passing numbers. So right now, the only one really applauding probably his agent as he thinks about angling for a new contract.
They run here with Dowdle.
And he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage.
Logan Wilson that time there to bring him down.
His carries tonight, they're getting up there, so maybe one of those every now and then is understandable.
I would agree with that. Understandable every now and then. Sometimes you come back and you fake it to him and go play action, but other times you say, okay, they got him on that one. We'll come back to him in another carry.
Left side to Lamb.
And they'll get this down to the 10. With that catch, he goes over 100 yards receiving on the night.
Well, this game is certainly pretty well over. They can go ahead and mark it in the win column. But as a defense, they don't want to get so soft now that everybody just throws the ball all over the place against them, gets big yardage, and puts points on the board. They have pride, too, on that side of the ball.
On first down, he'll drop to throw.
And he'll go right back to Lamb.
And he'll take it into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown.
CeeDee Lamb,
his second touchdown of the night.
And the Cowboys get a small measure of revenge as they cut into this fourth quarter deficit. He's got them out now to a 3-score lead here in the fourth quarter after that one, CeeDee. And, well, he looked right off the line like he knew that that ball was coming his way, and he secured it for 6 points.
Yeah, and I think when you're leading by a healthy margin already, it actually loosens you up and allows you to take maybe a few more chances and definitely play with more confidence, because he certainly saw something he could exploit in the defense, and he made sure to let his quarterback know, just get it to me. And the rest was all up to him, and he delivered and made it a 3-score game.
So after the touchdown, Aubrey now to kick this one away. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line.
The Bengals getting set to go.
Well, the win for them at this point seems pretty assured. I mean, still a decent amount of time left here in the fourth quarter, Charles, but you got the football. You're up 3 scores. They have to be feeling really good about where they're at.
I love your observation skills, partner, because I think you saw them charge onto the field fired up about another chance to get into the end zone. Looks to me like this group is ready to crush any hope left on the opposing sideline, and they want to do it with some gusto, too.
And for one of the first times all night, he is going to go nowhere as they bury him behind the line.
Well, that was one of the few times they've been able to contain him thus far. He's over 100 yards for the game, but he lost a bit off his total on that carry.
So the opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on 2nd and 12. Right back to Brown. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
133 yards rushing for him now as his big night continues. No doubt those are the types of carries they're looking for here, Charles. The lead in the fourth quarter. This is when coaches that have a reliable running game, they breathe a little easier on the sideline.
Yeah, they love the idea that they can take the air out of the football at this point of the game. That means they're really counting on that offensive line, counting on the runners, taking care of the football. Because you're going to tell your quarterback, hey, no time to be a hero. We're not going to throw it here. Just eat up that clock. And if you have the ball, they can't score. Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
It'll go down as a 2-yard loss, and it brings up a 3rd down. Finally, defensively, they have a little clip to show positive for actually stopping him running the football.
It's been a really long night for them, hasn't it? So they got a little bit of a win there, but let's face it, the vision that he's had running the football has carried his feet to the open spaces and to big yardage all night long.
It's a 6-yard gain, and it leaves them looking at a 4th down. This late in the game, Charles, I think you maybe seriously have to think about going for it.
Especially where they are in terms of field position, because this is almost like no man's land. Might hurt your punter because there might not be enough space, maybe too far for your field goal kicker. I'm like the old rule. Possession is 9/10 of the law. Possession is 9/10 of winning the game. Go for it. Get the 1st down. Close it out.
The Cowboys about set to take over on offense. Well, this game, it has had no shortage of offense. They've been able to put up a decent amount of points on this side, Charles. They just have not been able to keep pace with the other offense they're going against here.
Yeah, it's a good way of pointing things out because now it's not a total loss because, as you said, they've scored some points, so there's some plays they can build on, moments where the game plan actually worked. But overall, though, they were just out personnel. They were going up against a team that's playing at an elite level.
Two yards to go, 2nd down.
Rush.
Pass complete to Jalen Tolbert.
And he'll be tackled right on the chalk of the 45. 11 yards and a Cowboy 1st down.
A 3-score game here late. You can probably rule out the comeback, but certainly some kind of a moral victory to be had if they can get a few more points to close things out. And to that end, a nice pass play there to push things downfield.
Yeah, and we know in this league, a loss is a loss, and no one wants anything to count as a moral victory or, boy, something that feels a little bit cheap. But if they trim that lead down to just 2 scores, that's still a benefit to this squad.
It's a gain of 34.
Well, this game has certainly had no shortage of offense. Both teams have been revved up from the start. And here's yet another big play. Boy, both defenses have just got to be dragging out there because they've been run ragged throughout.
Back to throw, Rush. Looking middle, and that's complete. And able to get him down, but he does reach the 5. Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a 1st down again.
Well, those are the types of plays they probably wish they had made more of in the first 3 quarters, and this deficit is going to be tough to overcome here in the 4th, but a nice 1st down and a pickup on that throw.
Yeah, and this is where, as coaches, you're looking for effort and execution, even though the scoreboard is going against you. You want to find out who's going to fight, who's going to scrap, who's going to keep their heads up and continue to play.
At this point, down big, you'd have to imagine this defense, they're just going to sit back, blanket the field as best they can.
Yeah, this is actually the easy part of the game for them because, just as you noted, they can sit back, keep everything in front of them. But they've blanketed the field the entire game using a variety of coverages.
Touchdown, Cowboys! CeeDee Lamb, a 5-yard touchdown.
And the Cowboys have got it back to a 2-score game here in the fourth.
The fourth quarter touchdown there, back to a 2-score game, but time is not their ally.
No, it's not, partner. They still have a pulse, but it's probably a little weak right now. A lot of things have to go right in these final 2 minutes plus for them. I think they have to be thinking onside kick here, and we know how difficult those are to recover.
Aubrey good with a PAT.
And the lead will be cut down to 14.
Two scores down, three timeouts left. Still a chance if they can somehow get this one back. And this is going to be snuffed out. The Bengals recover. The risk-reward of the onside kick. When you don't get it, the risk comes out to play, and here they gave up great field position.
And that's the key to everything because you're trying your best to press advantages when you have them. And field position leads you to that type of play calling, and whether you want to blitz or whether you want to throw the ball deep, those types of things, now that they've given up that type of field position, the advantage is switched to their opponent.
And I think this defense knew what was coming as he is smothered behind the line.
No big surprise, Micah Parsons doing what he does so well, dropping him for a loss.
Defensively, no doubt they need a quick stop. Offensively here, maybe do you put it in the air on second down or do you go ahead and keep it on the ground, keep that clock moving?
A lot of people would ask that question, partner, because sometimes throwing the ball might actually be the path of least resistance. But in this case, it's a matter of trust. How much do you trust your quarterback? Because you throw the ball and it goes awry, you really don't look smart as a coach.
Yeah, and then you stop that clock.
He's going to get it again. Just looking to get forward and protect the ball.
And now right out of the 2-minute break, we'll get a timeout used defensively with a minute 56 to go.
Now this is a big third down, and you'd have to think we'd see a timeout right away if they can't stop him here.
They'll give this up the middle to Brown.
Yeah, good work there in open space. And he's got this all the way down now to the 32.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10.
Handing it off to Brown. Stops short of the 25, but that second effort got him a couple extra.
The Cowboys signal for their third and final timeout as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play.
They keep it on the ground. Again, it's Brown. And for one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, so they're left with a third down and 6.
Looked like he was trying to bounce it outside, but no success.
Yeah, sometimes you got to just figure out where you're going to go, and sometimes you just have to take it to another spot. In trying to get it outside, the defensive pursuit was there and just ran him down.
They'll fake it on the jet sweep, and instead, a handoff up the middle.
That he won't quite make it. He needed 6. He got about 5. Fourth down.
This team doesn't mind running the ball in any situation, and I thought he was going to get the first down the way the play developed, but the defense closed in and stopped him just about a yard short.
And no move to get the offense off the field. They'll stay put on 4th and 1. They'll try and run for it with Brown.
And even though he gets out of bounds to stop the clock, it's not going to matter. That first down going to be enough to write a finish to this one.
Starting to look like this drive, it may be the final nail in the coffin.
Well, this is why you work out so hard, right? This is why you spend all that time in the offseason. This is why you have those OTAs and mini camps for these situations, these scenarios, to run someone into the ground and secure a victory. Yeah, it's fun to kneel down in front of your home crowd, but when you go on the road, that band of brothers attitude, right? Just us against the world and get it done. How happy are they?
I remember a coach at a previous stop telling me, you get a win on the road, doesn't matter the opponent, get out of there like you stole something. And they did in this one.
Well, partner, under the lights in primetime, this offense, they gave the nation quite a show, putting up that many points to come away with what will certainly be a memorable win for them.
And, Brandon, I think it's as simple as this. Some players, some teams, they're just meant for the big stage. And when they get a chance to play in this type of atmosphere where all eyes are on them and all the lights are shining brightly, they show up and they show out.
So that'll just about do it for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to EASports.com. With that, we say good night from AT&T.